Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to some more MLB 15, the show coverage in the way of my Diamond Dynasty team. This is episode 2, and welcome back. You've gotten a bonus item, Matt Latos, by far my best starting pitcher at an 84 overall. Heck, my best pitcher overall at an 84. So we're going to go ahead and take that. See, we've gotten 3 stamps on our stamp bonus card right there. And getting right back into the squad. And like I said, I want to put Latos right at the top of that rotation. So I'll sub him in for my worst starting pitcher, which is De La Rosa. Then I'll do a little adjustment. I don't really know if it matters what order you put him in anyway, because when you go to play a game, they randomize your starting pitcher. But we'll just go ahead and do that. Also want to show you that I did go ahead and do the work and get the uniform set. They look very similar, if not identical, to the last couple years when I set them up and was all excited and didn't play a whole lot of Diamond Dynasty because I didn't really like the premise of all the fake players. But I think we'll be playing a lot more this year with the focus on the major leaguers and much more of a legit ultimate team feel to this. So, yeah, the SGU or Minneapolis YouTubers get their new look. You're seeing the home uniforms here, and then we'll pan on over to the road uniforms next. I went with the script YouTubers there at home, keeping with that blue and orange theme with my logo's colors. It's too bad you can't import your logo directly, like the logo you've got like on your computer, because I'd love to have my SGU logo kind of like I've put into the WWE 2K game. You know, they'd be able to put it on shirts and stuff. It'd be great to use that as your jersey logo. But since you can't, I went with this big block SGU on the road here. Go just kind of flip the colors as far as how the hats go, the batting helmets, the striping on the pants, all that stuff. So here you go. There's our batting helmets. I really do like how they've done this as far as, I mean, you just take a basic, you know, SGU script, and at least when it comes to like applying it to a hat, they give it the feel that it's really stitched on there. So, I mean, it's always been a nice touch like that. There's the dugout jackets for the road. So just an overview of the uniforms going into this Diamond Dynasty now that I got those set. Might tweak them once in a while if I get the urge to do so, but that's kind of the look I like my team to have. So now we're going to go in here, and I'll be playing the majority of my games, I would imagine, like in this extra innings or play against the computer. I'm not too much of an online guy. However, I know we're not going to move up ranks and things like that if we don't play online, but you know, I simply just don't really care. My focus is on building my team and collecting the collections and doing all that. So here's that randomizer for your starting pitcher, and who's it going to land on? Well, we're going to find out here when we get out here to play. I guess I don't know if I saw who it was or not. There you see the starting lineup, and I did go ahead early on before I even redeemed all my stubs. I had earned about, I don't know, 300 subs or so, and I went and bought Target Field at the time so I could at least have one Major League Stadium to hang out in here. So we're playing the Detroit Soul Snatchers. The Soul Snatchers, huh? Okay. They don't have a logo. That's a little weird. But at least he did do a little bit of design on the jerseys. That ball's going to be smacked to right center and get to the fence. Runner coming around second. He's going to try for third. Relay is going to cut him down. He's out at third base. So nice job getting the ball in quickly and avoiding a triple right there. This is going to be a grounder to second. This should get us out of the first inning. One thing that, I mean, I know why it's done. It's to speed up the games and, you know, to sift through it. But I would like a little more of the presentation in this mode because it makes it hard to edit videos. There's a base hit by Hunter Pence, one of my better hitters in my lineup, of course. And he will be on first base here now. You see Matt Kemp at the plate. Oh, couldn't handle it there, short. Everyone's going to be safe, first and second. This leads to a bases loaded opportunity for Mike Napoli. 0-1 count. Let's see what he can do here. Can they scratch some runs home in the first? That'll be up the middle. One run will score. Another run coming around. And he will also be safe as Matt Kemp slides safely into home. It's 2-0 SGU. All right, still runners out there, first and second. This one up the middle, but oh, a nice play. Flips it with the glove to start a double play. Nifty right there to get Detroit out of the inning. So we take that 2-0 lead, however, and let's see what we can run with that. I don't even know who we have on the mound here. I forgot to look. I believe that's Miguel Gonzalez. I think that's Gonzalez pitching today as they do throw the randomizer out there. Here's a new animation. I like this. Improved animations in the infield, including the catcher just being able to go ahead and tag the guy if he's near him instead of always having to make that throw down to first base. I've also noticed a lot more infield fielding animations that make it easier to throw while on the run, a lot of things like that. Just a little refined action here. So bottom of the fourth, still 2-0. Well, it was. Chirinos goes deep and gone. And here's what I'm talking about, presentation. No trot around the bases. That's it. I usually like to show more than that on a home run. And you get nothing. You get no replays or whatever. The presentation is stripped down so that these games can play faster. And I realize that that is a good thing, when especially if you're playing online and stuff. We are cruising here. Still got them shut out. We go into the seventh inning, 3-0 lead. And this is Corey Dickerson. He's going to go to the gap in a pinch hit spot right here. He's going to have a double for himself. Had a request to use Corey Dickerson and bring him off the bench there for a pinch hit double. He's now at third with one out, and that's Hunter Pence again with another hit and an RBI in this spot. 4-0 for the YouTubers. All right, cool. So let's try to steal a base here, shall we? Yeah, he's in there safe. All right, definitely letting Hunter Pence steal bases when he feels the need. Matt Kemp is going to line this one to right center, and it will get down for a hit. And what is going on with my base running? Should have had another run right there. Whoops. All right, well, we'll have to deal with it. Second and third, one out. This will be a ground out by Cespedes, but it will score the run that should have scored the play before. It's now 5-0. We go to the top of the eighth, and this is going to be hit well to right center field. It is in there for a hit. This looks like the play that we cut down a triple on in the first inning. This time, not so much. Throw is offline, and it will be a triple. In danger of giving up our first run of the game here, which isn't the end of the world, but it comes up with a strikeout and strands him there at third base. So no run for the Soul Snatchers. Despite their seven hits, let's go to the ninth inning. Two outs now. That is going to be a play at short and easily throws him out. SGU wins. The YouTubers take the game. Your player of the game, Miguel Gonzalez, with a great start here. Good quality start. He gave way to the bullpen, which also did quite well. And you got a victory here. So there we go. Knock down a team in the extra innings mode. And we'll have to see what we earn on this. I know you got a different percentage chance at all the cards. And wait, what's this? Your game has been added to the queue for processing. It will be viewable in your game history once processed. So I don't get my random card? What's up with that? I think to this point, I still haven't gotten that random card, even when I'm editing this. The next morning, which is a little frustrating, I did get a new item here for my Road to the Show guys. A new glove, even though I already have a gold level glove, I think. So I'm going to go to the marketplace, and since I have a few stubs to work with, I might tear a couple packs here before this thing is all said and done. Let's get a pitcher's pack. Let's go ahead and do that anytime now. I guess I was contemplating. There we go. Buy that for 1,000 stubs. And we will see what we get in this pitcher pack. Let's open it up, shall we? Pack management, here you go. Let's open it. See who we get. See if there's anybody we can put into our rotation or into our bullpen. You got the Lucky Clover item, whatever that is. Let's see here. Mid to low 70s. I bet you Balfour will fit in there. Some decent depth here. Oh, Brandon McCarthy. Yeah, he'll definitely fit into the rotation there at a 79 overall. And we got a batting glove also. So then let's go back and get a position player pack while we're at it. Do a couple packs and see where it leaves us. Now, I don't need outfielders. Well, I mean, I'll take a 90s plus outfielder if they want to give it to me. But, I mean, I think I more need infielders here. Let's see what we have. Anything usable? So far, nothing much. Jody Mercer. Hey, Kurt Suzuki. He's probably my best catcher to date by maybe 1 point. So we'll probably put Suzuki into the lineup. Go ahead and make a couple changes to the rotation. And also, I want to get at this creative player. Now, last year, the majority of your players were creative players because your MLB players expired after 10 games. There was no point in using them and spending your stubs on them. So you created everybody. Now you get one creative player. Basically serves as like a road to the show kind of guy to put in here. And I am bringing back Jumbo Hooker. Now, you guys would probably have to be longtime followers to know who Jumbo Hooker is. He was a character that my, well, now ex-wife played on her channel with a little help from me. Okay, a lot of help from me. And he was kind of beloved. So we bring back Jumbo Hooker. He's going to be our ringer, quote-unquote ringer here. But he's got a long way to go. You see the act of recycling players. So I only have a couple duplicates right now that I'm going to recycle. I'm going to have to feed him more often. But this is pretty dang cool here. You recycle and the stats go up for Jumbo Hooker. So he's got a long way to crack my lineup. Let's be honest. He'll be sitting on the sidelines until we can really beef him up. But there you go. Another look at my Diamond Dynasty team. We'll be playing this a lot more often this year because, frankly, the mode is a lot better. So I look forward to it. More Diamond Dynasty coming up. We'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Subscribe right here on YouTube to get daily videos from SGU, as well as frequent live streaming events. Give us a follow on Twitter for up-to-the-minute information on channel uploads. And last but not least, check out the SGU Facebook page. So what are you waiting for? Join in on the fun today!